showing you the second sun for a while. I figured out that it was not the simulator quite a while ago, and that there really is no simulator. It's all just been a narrative to hide the fact that God is here. That blue star would be Sirius, and it is occupied by the mother of creation, Sophia. Apparently, the waters above and below is a real thing. While I'm editing, I am able to see what looks like the most extravagant underwater world that I could ever imagine or dream of. I mean, it's just beyond. As I'm seeing these images, I'm blown away. Everything has a string of pearls or orb merkabas attaching it. I have no idea how everything works, but it looks like apartment complexes of orbs and huge spheres that have entire worlds inside. Monuments and wings and statues, or maybe they are actual beings. As everybody is seeing, the eyes in the sky have been off the chain. I got a message today that said, "The eyes in the sky today were real, not painted." So as it blows me away, I'm wondering, is everybody supposed to be able to see this now? And who am I to show people where heaven is and what heaven is? And is heaven different for everybody? But there's just too much fear happening. And when I know what's right above my head, as I have known for several months now, it takes away any chance of me being overcome by fear or giving up. I 100% have to share that. Humanity has had to go through some serious changes recently. We've had to go from thinking about the end, the complete end, and what that means, and then realizing that the earth is so vast and so big, and we are all one, and we're all in this together. And now we've all come to a place where I think we're ready for what is to come, because what is to come is nothing short of miraculous and everything we could have dreamed of. This is why we came here. Hold my heart, anybody can get the same images that I am by applying contrast twice, two or three times, and then all of a sudden, these images pop out. I truly don't understand how anybody can look up and see what I am seeing and not know that an actual Messiah is coming outside of humanity. We have a king returning, and actually it's a king and a queen, and they're already here, and I 100% believe that they are operating. They are helping to maintain control of the earth and everything that that entails. We needed the help. It would be crazy of us to think that we didn't. In the coming days, I just want everybody to keep in mind, while we still continue to figure this all out, keep in mind that we have been made to fear everything that is holy. So we think things that look evil are evil, but it turns out that that was a trick of the occult. So as I'm editing, I'm realizing that the iridescent fog cloud, the sparkly iridescent cloud that lays over everything, that seems to be the veil, and it seems to be very thin. It's all coming together now. Dr. Claudia Albers just did a video that spoke about how the sun is much larger and now has an electrical charge. Now, what have I been saying? And I can't take all the credit, although, you know, it has been my discernment while just reading through Gematria and also observing the sky over several months very closely. And yeah. Jupiter is rising. Saturn matrix is destroyed. It's a done deal. We can see it all around. And we can see Jupiter is rising, and now we have the science needed to back it up. And I love that it came from a woman physicist. I mean, I'll take it. We are all trying to figure out what is involved with the ascension as we each go through it individually. One of the biggest shifts has been with our bodies. That's another thing that we've really had to wake up from, realizing that we weren't dying, we weren't decaying, we weren't diseased. We were actually transforming and transmuting all of that negative energy, all of those things that were put in place to keep us from being our best, our happiest, our most joyous, and our healthiest selves. I have been lucky enough to have T. Taylor as a friend for a lot of my process. I was about a year into the really strange symptoms before I met her. So I definitely went down the road of the Harold, Bella, and the black goo, and all of it. And what a dark place to be. But you know, I have to say that it really is darkest before the dawn, because would you know that when I was reading the scariest stuff and I just didn't know how I would go on, I realized that I might not be able to realize all of my dreams in this lifetime. And I think it was at those moments where I died to this world. And I think that was very necessary. So I don't want to take that away from anybody. I just want the information to be there that actually Tony has discovered, and I can back it up, that this is just part of the alchemical process. There's 24 karat monatomic gold in the air. I've seen messages about it. We know all about the particles. We know a lot more than we started out knowing. We've gotten a lot of confirmation. And the 24 karat gold transforming our bodies from carbon into crystalline, well, our bodies are spitting out carbon, as Tony so awesomely noted a while back. It's really hard to get the word out, and Google doesn't like it very much. So that's just been added confirmation for me. But I am so confident that this is all about the alchemical process of divinity on earth, human flesh turning back to heavenly. And as you can see, we have heaven not far away. So it all makes sense to me now. The programming goes so deeply for each and every one of us. We are all getting rid of this programming every moment of every day that we continue to ascend. I continue to try to show people that not all of this is man-made. Not all of this is geoengineering. In fact, almost none of it is at this point. Throughout this video, you can see where they are actually chemtrailing, and they're tiny and the clouds are way in front of them. It's like heaven is coming in for a landing. On my next video, I will show where it looks like several huge celestial cities, I now know them to be, passed over us all day. But I wanted to get this out now. Hope all is well. Hope everyone's feeling good. If you're not, reach out to me, reach out to somebody. Go back, listen to some of our videos. You know, we can do this together. I still need you guys, and I'm always here for you. Peace of God to everybody.